And we are live. Good evening to all of the Dental Marketing Philippines followers, to all the dentists out there, to all of you who have been continuously supporting DMP or Dental Marketing Philippines. Again, I am Rochi Ruiz. I am the founder of this page. And together with me later is the co-founder of DMP, Dr. Kevin B. Mirasol. As you can see on the slide, today is going to be very special. Why? Because as I said, nandiyan po si Dr. Kevin, which we are going to talk to in a little later. But at this very moment, allow me to thank all of you for those who have supported us from the start of this pandemic. Well, since we start doing the webinars, we have reached, I think we have reached 58,000 people. So thank you very much. And we have 22,800 views. So for that, we do appreciate your support, and rest assured that we are going to provide you more information with regards to dentistry, with regards to marketing, with regards to digital dental marketing. These are all our mission to provide a very good understanding of this particular platform, because this is going to be the new norms. I think there will be a lot of learnings today. I'm sure for those who are watching right now, please prepare your paper and pen, as you will be learning a lot from this presentation. So, kitang-kita nyo po, nandiyan na si Dr. Kevin sa ilalim. But of course, I would just like to make mention that these are the past seminars or webinars that we have conducted. So, we have at work leadership in time of crisis, Q&A with the President of Philippine Dental Association. We also have its pandemic. So, I talk about the pandemic, its effect on your dental practice and dental business. You will be surprised, no? I did a presentation of the protocol April pa po, since the beginning of April, is probably this is last April 10, and I discussed there that these are the protocols and equipments that you have to use in your dental practice. And surprise, these are all being lectured now. So we're very fortunate that we were able to anticipate or forecast that hypothetically during that time. And also we were able to talk to Dr. Ruiz and the use of telemedicine. And again, Dr. Matthew Gillespie, all the way from Texas. We also were able to discuss a good friend of mine from Miami, Florida. So this is Dr. Sonia Dunbar talking about geriatric dentistry. We also discussed about the bleaching, everything about it. And of course, one of my favorite local dentists in the country, Dr. Lillian Lasaten Ebuen. I was able to talk to her and really giving us a good view of her protocol before pandemic. And of course, the things that she will do after this ECQ. And also I discussed with the minimally invasive implant, the Magic Core. So all of this, we're really fortunate we were able to successfully deliver all of these webinars for all the dentists in the country for free. And there is no registration needed for you to be able to enjoy all of these learnings. And I'm just very happy to be your conduit in providing such learnings. And this is just also one way to deliver very good service to the dentist. I firmly believe that we are really experiencing pandemic time today. But rest assured, if you're going to listen tonight, if you're going to learn this particular topic that Dr. Kevin will be discussing, you're not going to be scared. But I'm warning you, your business is in danger, no, if you're not going to do this. Again, 3 days ago, we were able to have the dental ergonomics. This is the proper posturing, the hands, etc. All about the discipline, all about the learning curves, techniques, positioning of dental chairs, and everything about dental ergonomics. So we're able to discuss and talk to the one and only dental architect in the country, Dr. Arke De Leon. Pinsan ko yata po yan, De Leon. No? And also, today is May 10. Just count 3 days. And makikita nyo na naman po ako. No? Ako po, si Rochi Ruiz, I will be discussing about kano. Kano. Ano ba yung kano? No? Is, kano is basically equivalent to HM. Ano ba yung HM? How much, no? So, sawak-sawa na po ko yung marinig ng how much, how much, how much. But this time, I'll be talking about the three relevant topics with the bonus slides on marketing plan. So the first topic, which I'm very proud, you know, that I'd like to discuss it with you, the three things that you have to know and realize and analyze. The second topic is I'm going to share with you the new norms which we are going to apply in our clinic. Of course, you do have your own protocol in accepting and patients, but I will just be sharing what I'm going to do with our clinics. Okay, clinics. Number three is I'm going to let you identify how much kano you're going to charge your new patients. So this is going to be tricky. This is going to be, of course, a case-to-case basis, but I was just going to provide you probably the right information, the right computation on how to do it. Okay? And the last one is a marketing plan for your dental practice. The third quarter of this year, or fourth quarter of this year, and probably the rest of 2021. So it is a must for you to tune in on that particular date. And of course, all of these webinars can be seen on my YouTube channel. Please go to my YouTube channel and you're gonna learn a lot. All of these are for free. Roche Ruiz MBA Marketing. You can just check it out there. All the videos, all about tips of dental marketing together with the launch of Dental Marketing Philippines last year. And also, if you wanna check out my page, Roche Ruiz Master Marketing, and of course, we do have Smile Line Elite Group of, and of course, Dental Marketing Philippines. Ang dami ko po na discuss, ano? But on May 15, just 2 days after my lecture, I'm going to give you something to look forward to. And this is what we call dental, or kwentong dental, kwentong pasaya. Ano po ba ito? So win prizes that you may use to get back to your traction. And click the link below and you make sure you are locked in. And ang title po nito is Kwentong Masaya, Good Vibes, Kwentuhang Tips, and guidance. Makinig, manood, at i-share, at makisama sa pasaya. Okay? So, ito po ay napakasayang kwentuhan. At kasama niyo po dyan, ako na naman po. At saka si Dr. Kevin. And we have a special guest, Dr. Romeo. So, this is gonna be May 15. Mark your calendar. And this is gonna be awesome. This is gonna be a really, really great opportunity for all the dentists. So, tama-tama po. Today is before dinner, May 15 po, 7:30 p.m. Okay? So, alam ko po, we are all very excited to learn about this digital marketing. And of course, I'm also very excited to provide you more information through this very good dentist. And yeah, nasa baba po siya, nasa baba, okay? Dr. Kevin, kamusta?
Hi sir, I'm okay. Thank you for this opportunity in sharing the presentation about dental branding.
Wow.
So, I'm ako from an island dito sa Visayas area.
Okay, so I would just like you to greet all of the dentists who are watching right now. We have a lot of dentists who are tuned in right now. We really appreciate all your support. But before you greet that, I would just like to give shout out Dr. Adina Lagman. Good evening po. Dr. Ariel Babalus, Dr. Gina Corpus Diaz, Dr. Marian Horvilin Bravo, Dr. Ellen Kaidik, Dr. Elena Loida Apuang Pedrosa. Good evening. And Dr. Kevin, greet them.
Hi, good evening. Good evening. Welcome po. Thank you for taking your time sa pag-attend.
Okay, so wag na po natin patagalin. I think ako po medyo nagpa-practice na po ako ng ganito, but I'm very excited to learn more. So I hope you have your pen and papers there, and I will formally introduce our guest, you know? Of course, he will have slides for his presentation, for his profile, but I would just like to really present Dr. Kevin. He is a dental lifestylepreneur. He is a dentist by profession. He is a digital expert. Yes, he is a digital expert. A lifestyle dentist, private. He has a private practice and he's also a government dentist. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Kevin V. Mirasol. Dr. Kevin, take it away.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Hi, good evening. Live na ba, sir? Okay na?
Yes, go ahead. Doc, okay. Ready na. Ready na kami.
Hindi ko nakikita slides ko, sir. Ayun, slides. Ah, late lang siguro.
Oh, yan. Hindi. Okay. Doon, yan.
Okay, so. Good evening po sa lahat. Thank you for taking your time sa pag-attend. Welcome, hello, and happy Mother's Day din. Timing talaga yung presentation na to kasi happy Mother's Day po sa lahat ng dentists dyan na nanonood. Welcome aboard. Okay, so the title of the presentation po is the SMB, Social Media Branding for Dentists. Hindi po ito yung SMB na alam natin na yung iniinom natin. San Miguel Beer, hindi po yon. It's social media branding for dentists. So, okay. So, let's get the party started. I hope ready na lahat. So, okay. But first, once again, I want to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Kevin Mirasol, the Lifestyle Entrepreneur Dentist from ProDM, the Pro Digital Marketing Agency. I'm also a co-founder ng Dental Marketing Philippines. I help entrepreneurs, dentists, and business owners how to market their business online using proven strategies. Yan. I'm also a family man, dental practice owner. Yan. Kagaya ng sabi kagina ni Sir, dental practice owner. What is our main topic for tonight? It's all about dental branding. We will talk about branding ng ating practice and branding din ng ating mga kung paano natin ipipresent more on sa social media. Last July kasi we launched the Dental Marketing Philippines together with Sirochi Ruiz. And I discussed there about the dental digital marketing naman. I talk about the power of digital marketing in enhancing our practice. And also we did a workshop. And now naman, we'll talk about dental branding. So, what will you learn? What will you learn in this presentation about dental branding? First, the brand building essentials for dental practices. Tatalakayin natin yan. Then, you will also learn how to start an effective dental social media branding in Facebook and Instagram. Then you will learn how to do ethical branding in social media. Questions and answers at the end. So I really recommend na please take notes para mamaya po maganda po ang ating discussion and mas maintindihan nyo po kasi para sa lahat ng nanonood. Yung mga questions nyo is matalakay din nila at matutunan din po nila. This is also the time that we set new goals about things we want to learn, accomplish, and change this time of pandemic or even after this pandemic. I believe that we are all students of the classroom of life. Tama? Sabi nga ni Michelangelo, I am still learning at 87. Because learning is a never-ending process. Okay? So what is a brand? So Kevin, ano ba talaga ang brand na yan? Okay, before I show the definition of brand, I want also to show you the favorite quote of mine when it comes to branding by Jay Danzi. Your smile is your logo, your personality is your business card. How you leave others feeling after having an experience with you becomes your trademark. Diba? Ang ganda. Diyan pa lang sa quote na yan, parang punong-puno na at parang kuha mo na agad kung paano talaga ipipresent ang ating dental practice sa ating mga audience. What is a brand? A brand is not a logo. Yan, another famous logo ito ng famous na cellphone or mobile company. And this, before I forget, disclaimer lang po. We will have a lot of brands. I will mention a lot of brands here. I'm not really associated with them. And we will just use them for educational purpose kasi nga we are talking about branding. Okay? So, a brand is not a logo. Okay, another favorite bag ng ating mga butihing dentista dyan. A brand is not a logo. Okay, another favorite ito ng ating Master Rochi Ruiz. Ito yung BMW na car. So, Doc, ano ba talaga? Kanina ka pa, what is really a brand? Okay, simple lang. A brand is a company's reputation and promise of quality and excellence. Okay? So, highlight natin yan. It is a promise of quality and excellence. Oh, for example, when it comes to mga coffee shop, unang-unang pumapasok sa mind natin, di ba, is Starbucks. Okay? So, they have provide a great reputation na when it comes sa mga cafe. Yan. Another example natin sa mga fast food. Jollibee, they have a great brand na rin. Lalong-lalo na sa mga kids. Nare-remember ko nga minsan yung anak ko. Every time makita niya yung logo ni Jollibee, sabi niya, Jollibee, Jollibee. Okay. Diyan pa lang, you can see na grabe yung branding ng Jollibee. Because anywhere you can see Jollibee logos, anywhere talaga. Okay? So, that is all about brand. So, what is the difference between dental marketing and dental branding? May pagkakaiba ba o wala, ganun. So, there is a push and pull concept when it comes to dental marketing and dental branding. Dental marketing is any effort to promote your practice and services to push, okay? To push. Push your name on a larger audience and get sales or patients, okay? Dental marketing, to push. Dental branding is seeks to pull. Yeah, remember, to pull people through communicating your dental practice values, culture, and characteristic. Yan, madali lang tandaan. When it comes to dental marketing, it's a push concept. Dental branding, pull. Pull, parang itong attraction. Parang may magnet. Yan, i-discuss natin yan mamaya as we go along on this presentation. In order for dental marketing to work, you need dental branding and vice versa. Team sila, kumbaga. Hindi mag-work ng maganda yung dental marketing mo kung sa dental branding pa lang, hindi na maganda yung umpisa mo. Okay? So, there's a two kinds of branding that I want you to achieve. And any dentist or any practice owners na gusto itong i-achieve, and even me, gusto kong i-achieve to. Two kinds of branding that I wanted to achieve, ano? Brand equity and brand loyalty. Okay, so, what is brand equity? Dr. Kevin, what is brand equity? Brand equity is the perception of value or superiority of product or service in the eyes of consumer. The perception of value and superiority of product in the eyes of consumer. Okay? Highlight natin ang value. Great example natin dyan is, tingnan natin yung ano, when it comes to antibacterial soap. Di ba yung una-unang na ano sa isip natin, kung saan superior na yung brand, Safeguard. Mas malakas yung value niya. Okay? So, compare sa other na ano, na soap. Brand equity in dental clinic naman is expressed in the form of consumers choosing the clinic and following recommended treatment with little or no regard for price. Galing, di ba? Kapag itong na-achieve natin yung brand equity with little or no regard price, kahit napakalaki, napaka-taas pa ng benta mo ng veneers, ng implants, babalik at babalik sa iyong patient. Yan. Napakaganda kapag na-achieve natin that we have a great value doon sa ating clinic at sa practice natin and even sa mga services natin. What is brand loyalty naman? Brand loyalty is a client's commitment to continually repurchase a product or service regardless of the marketing pressure generated by competitors. Yan, kahit may mga dumating pang ibang company, sa iyo babalik at babalik ang mga consumers. Okay? Best example natin dyan nito, when it comes sa mga malls. Unang-unang, di ba, favorite na natin na malls is SM. We have a great brand na, tapos loyal na talaga yung mga Pinoy. And another strategy nila dyan is minsan, they produce a brand loyalty program. Example dyan ng SM Advantage Card, di ba? mas maraming gustong mag-shopping kasi nga may brand loyalty program, which is very applicable also in our dental clinic. Brand loyalty in our dental clinic is expressed in the forms of clients continually returning to the clinic with little or no regard for competing options. Yan. So kahit may mga dumating pa mga dentista or mga other clinics dyan sa harapan mo, dahil naka-establish ka na ng good brand, good value, ang perfect service, darating at darating talaga ang pasyente sa'yo. Babalik at babalik sila. So, yun nga yung strategies na tinuturo ko palagi you can implement brand loyalty programs sa clinic. Ini-apply na rin ito sa mga spa. If you notice nyo siguro sa mga ano pa yung iba, sa mga massage yan, sa mga sex ano, shop. Ini-implement na yan. Kumbaga, mina-anticipate, may nilook forward yung ating pasyente. So, it's really important, maybe think about it na magkaroon kayo ng ang ano brand loyalty program para mga may mga points kumbaga. Okay? So a strong brand will protect you from economic volatility and competitive challenges. Yan, palagi natin tandaan. So that's why please make it a goal na i-achieve ang positive natin na brand equity and brand loyalty. Okay, so ayan, I always do a lecture flow kapag nag-present ako. So, para gusto ko talaga mas maintindihan ng lahat. And natapos na natin ang brand. Alam na natin ang brand, ang two kinds of brand. So, we will go na sa blue, sa yellow, para mas ma-achieve natin ang progressive and productive social media branding for dental practice. So, ayan, sa blue. Let's proceed. Okay, kaya pa. Dental brand identity development. Ito yung blue. Ito yung steps natin kung paano ipipresent ang ating brand. Papamagitan ng mga steps kung paano itong gagawin na mas tama. Okay? By doing this identity development. But first, what will be your dental brand identity? Ngayon pa lang, isipin niyo po. Or maybe, yung iba dyan, they already know kung paano nila ipresent ang kanilang clinic, ang kanilang practice. Okay? So, maybe a master in dental surgery, right? Hindi pa, di ba, when it comes, pag narinig pa lang na si ganito, si doctor ganito, magaling sa, magaan yung kamay niyan. So, parang yung branding mo, ang galing. Doon ka na naka-establish ka na pagdating sa mga surgery, ikaw agad yung naaalala nila ng mga pasyente. Okay? Or maybe, a well-known pediatric dentist. Yan, kung paano ipipresent. Meron naman kasing medyo ayaw nila sa mga pedo patient. Meron naman mga dentista na focus talaga sa mga bata. Okay? So, let me show you the four steps to a great dental brand identity. Para po sa mas ma-effective, ito po yung four steps na pwede natin i-follow at mga gagawin para ma-achieve natin ang great dental brand identity. First, number one is to create a clear vision statement. Number two, design a great logo. Number three, develop a tagline. And number four, establish design standards. Isa-isahin po natin yan. Create a clear vision statement. Okay, guys, colleagues, this is an advanced exercise already. Please screenshot and these four questions. Dahil when it comes to vision statement, the number one, this will be your assignment na mamaya pa lang po, isasagutin nyo po before kayo matulog. Because vision statement ay kine-create po na kayo mismo ang makakasagot ng four questions. Okay? Kasi po, iba-iba po yung practice natin, iba-iba po yung vision natin. So that's why I really recommend you to write this or screenshot, then sagutin nyo or assignment natin ito, exercise na agad. Sagutin nyo po mamaya before kayo matulog or naisip nyo na. Okay? So the four questions, how will you treat each and every patient? What level of service will you provide? What is your promise of clinical excellence? How will you show your expertise? Yan. So, dyan pa lang. Pag naasagutan nyo po yan, parang you will have a good vision statement na. Because it's really important to start right. Diba? Dapat tama yung ating simula dito sa ating steps sa great dental brand identity. But always remember lang that dental branding is a way to communicate your dental practice values, culture, and characteristics. Mag-base kayo dito para mas madali nyo pong sagutin itong four questions. Okay? Na-screenshot na? Okay, sige. Number two, design a great logo. Yan. This is my favorite part. When designing a great logo, I know naman some dentists are very creative. Medyo may pagka-artist talaga mga dentista. So anyone can do this, or maybe you can hire an expert, but I know anyone can do this. So we have a lot of apps naman na pwede nyong gawin ang inyong logo. Maybe, I know yung others may mga logo na, but first, kung gusto nyong gawin ulit, I really recommend that to have a clean logo, professional looking dapat siya, and unique. Unique yung logo natin. At unique yung logo. Basta always remember that logo is the visual presentation of the values and personality of your brand. That's why it's really important to have a unique or a very creative na professional looking na logo. Because it is the visual representation. So mamaya, maybe you can think about na tingnan ulit ang logo nyo, may mga logo na kayo, because logos can change naman. Okay? Tingnan nyo kung pwede, kasi pwede nyo maging assignment yan ngayong ECQ na pwedeng i-change ko siguro ang logo ko, mga ganyan. Isipin nyo kung okay na ba, contento ka na sa logo mo. Because logos can change, ito yung example natin. Yan. Ito yung sa Apple eh. Tingnan nyo yung kanyang pinakaunang logo. Nakalagay dyan, Apple Computer Kodak. Okay? Parang ganda ng concept nila. Ito yung apple tree, pag nakikita nyo. Apple tree, ito yung apple na fruit. Then may taong nagbabasa dyan sa ilalim. Dyan pala, makikita nyo muna yung concept nila. Kumbaga, maganda yung pagkakagawa. Pero hanggang mag-change sila, kasi nag-iiba rin yung mas classy siya tingnan. Okay, so use your logo everywhere possible. Kahit saan, ikalat nyo. Saan ba, Doc? Saan ba pwedeng ilagay yung mga logos natin? Of course, sa mga business card natin, it's very important. Sa mga bags, sa mga giveaways natin na bags, sa mga tumblers. Okay? We have a strategy there, tip ko lang. Last time, you can always run a giveaway or contest sa social media natin. Then, tapos doon natin, kapag sa mga prizes nyo, you can print your logo. Okay? Tapos hanggang sa pakalat na yan. Last time, ito yung example namin sa clinic ko, giveaway ng mga, nung Christmas. Ito yung Christmas giveaway ko. Ito palagi, nag-ano ka ng Christmas giveaway. Parang consistent na yan. Tapos, pag next year, madami pa dyan. May mga March Madness giveaway. Kumbaga, you should be a calendar din para sa giveaway, para kung sa engagement ng ating mga viewers doon sa iyong social media accounts and profiles. So, ayan. Anywhere may logo dyan. Dito may logo dun sa likod. Dito, nilagyan ko ng logo. Okay? So, kumbaga, total branding talaga. Kalat nyo. Saan pa? No, Kevin, saan pa namin pwede nilagay? Use your logo in social media accounts. Lagay nyo po dyan. Dapat maganda yung ating Facebook cover. Sa profile, nandun yung mga logos. Ito yung example natin. In your dental website, yan, dito rin, of course, and sa lahat ng online platforms na available kayo. Okay? So, number three, ayan na. Number three is to develop a tagline. Develop a meaningful and concise statement that captures the essence of your clinic. I noticed ang iba, when I reviewed ng other clients ko, wala pa silang tagline. Oh, may logo sila, but it's really important to have a tagline because it will sell the benefits. Yan ang pinag-importante. As long as you sell the benefits, not the features. Please put tagline. Ngayon pa lang, you should, ano na, isipin nyo na kung wala pa po kayong tagline. Oh, for example, ito. Lakas nang dating kapag may tagline eh. Yung sa Nike. Okay, just do it. Parang galing na ganun dating. Ito naman sa BMW na car, the ultimate driving machine. Galing, di ba? Ito pa yung iba. So please, ngayon pa lang, kung wala kayong tagline, pag-isipan nyo na. Ito yung mga sample of dental taglines. Experience the gentle difference. Ayan. Dentistry you can't wait to tell your friends about. Dentistry with a heart. Ayan, parang si Pia works back lang. Okay? So dedicated to excellence, dedicated to your smile, a leading visionary in dental care. So, please, develop a tagline pero dapat unique siya and naaayon doon sa mga sa three na steps natin. Okay? So, ito yung example ba? More examples. So, FedEx, when there is no tomorrow. Parang galing, di ba? Parang ang bilis. Ang bilis na. Ito naman, KFC, it's finger licking good. Parang sarap. Sarap na agad. Narinig pa lang yung ano nila eh, yung tagline. How about sa mga famous brands naman sa dentistry? Vaseline, the clear alternative to braces. Yan. It sells the benefits. Una-una pa lang na mabasa mo yung tagline ng Vaseline. Galing, parang it will sell the benefits na talaga. Okay. Same here with Sensodyne. Clinically proven relief for sensitive teeth. When it comes naman, di ba, sa mga pagdating na sa sensitivity, Sensodyne agad nang nire-recommend natin. Kaya nga, itong dalawang brand to, nakabuild talaga sila ng great branding. Tagline pa lang eh. Okay. Oh, Sir Ochi, I borrowed your sa page nyo. Ito naman yung example natin for the dental clinics. Ito yung kay Sir Ochi, yung kay JR. Ito yung kanilang tagline. Great smile begins within. Galing, parang inner health talaga, no? So, Mirasol Dental Clinic, this is mine, the MDC. Healthy teeth within reach. Okay. Healthy teeth within reach kasi nga, I practice sa island part. So, I want to portray na, so kay pakita, i-present na very accessible anywhere ka na magkaroon ng dental health services. Ayan, so all the four steps must be related. Yung ano mo, yung logo, yung tagline, yung one, yung steps pa, yung ano ba yung pang-apat. Ayan, eto na. Number four is to design standards for your marketing materials. Number one, di ba, yung visual statement. Number two is the logo. Number three is the tagline. And eto na, number four, dapat coordinate shot of colors. Design standards. Kumbaga, kung ano yung naumpisa mong gagamitin, yan na rin yung gagamitin mo sa mga social media posts mo, sa mga, for the marketing materials. Huwag nyo pong change. Kung minsan nag-create kayo ng post nyo, halimbawa nag-create kayo ng post nyo for Facebook page, please, with a touch of the color of your brand. Kumbaga, blue color, dapat may touch of blue. Okay? Because design standard consists of fonts, textures, shapes, color schemes, photos, and even language style. Okay. Okay, ayan. Great example natin sa mga companies like PayPal. PayPal is the payment option for online. Okay. You have one color lang, actually. I recommend you have a one or two colors para sa inyong branding, sa logo nyo, sa taglines. It's important kasi para professional looking siya, neat looking siya. Okay. Pag naglampas sa three colors, okay naman. Okay naman. Ito, two colors lang to. Two colors na to kasi yellow and green. But ito, from light, one color lang talaga pinanggalingan. From light to dark lang. Galing ng combination, di ba? From light to dark. Yan. Galing ng pagkakagawa. So, ayan, ito yung great example ko naman for my dental clinic. I have two colors lang, white and blue. Ito lang, may light blue and dark blue. Okay, parang color coordination is important. Okay, once again, what are the four steps to a great dental brand identity? Okay, number one, I hope my vision statement na kayo. Number two, designing a great logo. Number three, develop a tagline. And number four, establish design standards. Ayan, mabilis ba? Okay, tapos na natin yung dalawa para makamit yung ating progressive and productive social media branding for dental practice. May dalawa pa. Okay, proceed po tayo. Okay. Sa yellow one, ano ba yung yellow, Doc Kevin? It's the SMB. Oh, Sir Rochi, ngayon pala tayo nag-start sa SMB. Okay, social media branding. Okay, pero hindi, ito na yung nasa ano tayo, nasa kalagitnaan na po tayo. Pero mahaba po yung susunod na dalawa, ha? So, social media branding. Ano yung matutunan natin dito? Why social media? Number two, how to start in Facebook. And number three, Instagram dental branding basics. Yan. Why social media branding? No, Kevin, sa dinami-dami ng online platforms that we can promote our services and our dental practice, why social media? Diba? No, Kevin, we have TikTok naman, we have YouTube naman, we have Google naman, why social media? Okay, first, social media is very cheap and pwede mo rin matutunan. Plus, it's very targeted. Kumbaga, you can choose kung sino yung pwede mong kung sino yung pwede mong ipakita ng iyong branding or ng iyong marketing. Okay, so, why social media? Because consumers are spending more time online and mobile usage. Dentists, business owners, and marketers need to target their audience where they spend time. Sabi nga nila, kung saan yung isda, doon tayo mamimingwet, right? So, I really recommend naman to start in one or two platform if you are a beginner. Can start sa Facebook, the number one social media for branding and marketing. Then, next is Instagram. For the beginner, please start in Facebook. Because 32% of respondents think that social media dentists cannot be successful without is Facebook. Tama naman, di ba? Okay, so as we go along sa mga presentation, may mga real talk tayo dito, ha? So, ayan yan sa Dentavax survey, 32%. Minsan kasi, I also thank Mark Zuckerberg, yung founder ng Facebook. Napakagaling, sobra. Because of Facebook, tayong mga small to medium business owners or even the large companies, nagkaroon ng time or para matutunan mag-market sa Facebook and in a very affordable way. Okay? Sobra. Ano magaling pa dito, when it comes sa social media marketing or particularly in Facebook, you can also learn. Dentist, anyone can learn. Mas mahirap pa yung kapag nagsisimula ka sa pagbunot ng ipin. Mas madali po matutunan ng Facebook marketing. Okay? So, how to start in Facebook branding? Apat lang yung kailangan natin. I know others may mga Facebook page na dyan and maybe okay na din yung mga Facebook pages, no? But ito, i-review lang natin. You have an account, of course, dapat. Facebook dental page. Facebook page profile is different sa Facebook page, okay? Facebook page, you can create unlimited Facebook page. Sa Facebook profile naman, ano lang siya? Isa lang. But, hindi ba dumadami yung mga trolls na tinatawag scammers? Pero, I recommend na one or two Facebook na profile, okay na po yun. Kasi, Facebook is very strict when it comes to privacy. Dapat naka-customize din. Customize yung Facebook page nyo. Then, naka-links to other networks. Okay? So, ngayon, sa customization, mag-out ako dito sa aking presentation. I will go to my Facebook page, then I will show you para makita nyo po kung mga dapat i-troubleshoot nyo mamaya kung may kulang doon sa inyong Facebook page. Okay? So,
okay, let's do it. Ayan.
Okay. So,
while you're doing that, Dr. Kevin, I would just like to say hi to all the viewers. We are reaching 100 viewers already, and we'd like to really, we do appreciate your watching tonight presentation. So I hope you just wait for your dinner as we are still have we have a lot of things to discuss. I would just like to say shout out, no, Dr. Kevin. Unang pasada ito ng mga shout out natin. Doktora Pepe, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Doktora Irene Mago, Doktora Elsie Calao, Dr. John Clutter, Dr. Maria Elizabeth Manalastas, Dr. Harris Tan, Dr. Ann Gamus, as always, Dr. Sheryl Kaidik, Dr. Doc Peter Ong from Cebu, we have from Cagayan, Dr. Marco Colala, he's the president of Cagayan Dental Chapter, Dr. Pascual from St. Luke's, also from Muntinlupa, Dr. Noel Develen, Dr. Lichad Lau. So we do have a lot of people, dentists who are watching right now from all over the country. Keep on tune in, and we're going to discuss more about this one. So we are on the third phase. So we are on the blue level ba o green level na? Tama,
Dr. Okay, Kevin. Okay, sa social media branding na tayo.
Take it away.
Okay. So, ito yung dental Facebook page, okay? Gusto ko lang ang mga pointers na gusto kong ma-ano nyo. First, you should have a great logo in your Facebook page profile. This okay. One.
Dok Kevin, are you showing your Facebook page?
Yes, yes, it's my Facebook. Hindi
siya naka-share screen, so that would just like to show also to our viewers. So pakita natin. So you end screen first, the other one.
Add screen.
End screen mo yung old slides, then we're going to proceed with your Facebook page.
Okay, wait lang. I will stop the first one, sir.
Yeah.
I will stop the screen.
Yes.
First one.
Yes.
Okay.
Ayan.
Then, so, para po mas maintindihan natin, it's a good thing.
Correct. So this is how we do it.
Screen with share screen, then this one, the entire screen. Yeah. Right?
Wala pa. Yan.
Yeah, that's it?
Yan. Go ahead, Doc. Nice. Take it away.
Okay, so. Okay, that's it, guys. This is my Facebook page, a sample para po. So, we'll troubleshoot po natin kung may mga pointers kayo na pwedeng i-edit doon sa inyong Facebook page. Okay, so like I said before, we should have a good, a good Facebook profile. Yung logo nyo, pwede nyo ilagay. And Facebook page cover. Pwede kayo magpagawa, or I know we have a lot of creative dentists naman na pwede nyo gawin. Okay? And ang very important pa dito ang story, the our story section. Dito po tayo makikita natin yan sa about. Yan, our story. Please lagyan nyo po ng content yung our story. Kasi I noticed yung iba, wala silang story. Para professional naman po, maglagay ko ng story nyo dyan, yung mission nyo, yung statement na vision statement nyo, yan. Para po sa additional branding. And ano pa? Sa services, yan. Pwede rin yung ilagay yung services. Okay? Please put sa services nyo, yan. Kung ano yung mga services nyo, mga highlights ng ating mga services. And reviews. It's really important na you ask patient for reviews or recommendation dito kahit sa Facebook page lang, because nowadays people will always look for dentists online, tama? So always put reviews, ask for reviews dito sa inyong review section. Ito. Okay, so ano tatandaan natin? Yung Facebook cover, Facebook profile, ang services, ang reviews, and ang our story section. Ito yung story. Paki-edit niyo po yan. You can edit this when you are in a desktop only, but in mobile, hindi po siya ma-edit. Yan, sa about section. Yun lang po. Okay na yan. Very good na yung branding nyo. Ready to market na. Okay? So we will go back in the other... We'll continue to my presentation. Stop sharing lang, sir. Stop sharing. Then, same scare. Share screen using application window. Yeah. Okay. Klaro na? Okay, let's continue. Tatapos na po natin kung ano yung Facebook branding, kung baga yung pag-setup ng tamang Facebook page. And please na, I hope natandaan niyo siya. Okay. So, sorry. Ano ba? Sana ba? Sorry. Sorry. Dito na tayo sa... Ayan. Okay. So, okay, natapos na po natin. I hope na may mga checklist kayo, yung services, yung about story or about doon sa dental practice nyo, and Facebook cover at Facebook logo na ano. And dapat nakalink din siya sa other social networks like Instagram, LinkedIn, Pinterest, yan, mga yung mga active social media for branding ng dentist. Okay, wow, early gift. 2020 version. Hindi pa tayo tapos, may early gift na ako. Okay, message me to download or go to this link. Yan, I go to this link for the Facebook Attraction Marketing for Dentist ebook. Okay, guys, the best part here is that you have a good Facebook branding na. So the problem na lang is how to market your brand. So this ebook can help. Okay, this will guide you sa Facebook marketing nyo. Facebook Attraction Marketing for Dentists. You can download here in this link or you can message me directly or it will appear in the comment section. Okay? So, yan. Number three na tayo for the SMB for Dentists. The Social Media Branding for Dentists. Number three is Instagram Dental Branding Basics. Instagram Dental Branding Basics, ano yung mga need natin? Instagram now is very popular when it comes to photo marketing. Yung laban kasi sa Instagram is all about good photos. Yan. Okay? Dapat maganda yung mga captures mo na ipopost doon sa Instagram. What are the basic needs for dental Instagram branding, Doc Kevin? Ano ba talaga kung paano mag-start? What we need? Instagram account, of course, dapat an active Instagram account. When it comes to Instagram account, you should have a five yung pwede mong gawing Instagram, which is account, which is very good kasi sa Facebook profile naman is isa lang, di ba, or two. Yung maganda rin sa Facebook is you can create unlimited Facebook page. Sa Instagram, you can create five Instagram account. I'm sorry. Number two, good camera or phone. Okay, you should invest in a good camera or phone para sa mga captures natin na share sa Instagram. Number three, good photo editor. Okay, this is available doon sa Facebook Attraction Marketing na ebook. May mga apps ako doon na recommended para sa pag-edit nyo ng mga photos nyo na ilalagay doon sa Instagram or even sa Facebook page. And number four, Instagram Influencer Advanced Strategy. This is advanced strategy and I will show you later kung paano dyan gagamitin ang mga Instagram influencers. Yan. Instagram account, good camera or phone, good photo editor, yan. Yan lang yung kailangan natin for branding. Instagram is widely considered the primary platform for many brand campaigns, so you need to ensure the dental practice as an established account that is frequently feed and with eye-catching posts. Yan, dapat consistency is the key para sa successful natin na Instagram branding. Yan, if you notice nyo, ito yung Instagram. This one, okay. Usually yung daming posts, I notice halos yung foreigners nag-focus na rin sa Instagram branding ng kanilang dental practice. Yan. The use of Instagram influencers. Yan. Ito naman. Ito yung mga tips ko dyan or yung mga ano ko kung paano talaga mag-work itong influencer. Find an influencer or celebrity who fits your market. The relationship needs to be authentic and the influencer should reflect your brand as well as have enough followers to make engagement count. Okay? This is very popular na dito sa Philippines. Filipino dentists now use influencers or celebrities to market or to showcase their brand and their services. Right? Ang dami ko na notice. Ang iba nga dyan sila nagsimula. Halos dyan sila mas nakilala dahil sa mga celebrity na kanilang patient or models. Best part dyan, others will pay them. Dentists will pay them or ang iba relatives ng dentist or ang iba ay loyal patient. So, how do we pay the celebrity influencers? Okay. Iba is free, ano, free treatment. Pwede na. Depende sa class ng celebrity or influencer. And iba naman is, ano, you call this free treatment, kagaya ng mga veneers, yan, mga whitening, kagaya nito. Ang iba, direct payment. Ang iba, libre na kasi nga, kilala nila or ano, relative. So, ayun. And, yan sila kumikita. Kaya ang dami ngayong influencers, yan. Sabihin ko sa inyo, ang daming influencers ngayon, lalo na rin sa vlogging. Dami na rin nagbablog. Pwede rin nilang ma-promote ang kanilang ano doon, mga practice doon. Kapag nag-hire sila ng mga vloggers. So, sa Facebook page, it also works sa Facebook page. Minsan, ano to, sasabihin ko sa inyo. Minsan, di ba, notice nyo, nagsishare kayo palagi ng mga memes sa Facebook page, sa mga ano nyo, kasi natutuwa kayo. Have you ever wondered kung bakit ang daming ganito ng mga Facebook page? Okay, so they are Facebook page influencers then. Kung may Instagram influencers, they are also Facebook page influencers. Kasi, okay, so maybe they're doing it for passion or gusto lang nila mag-share ng quality content. And pero, ang main part dyan is to have income. Okay? Kasi, Facebook page influencers, pag dumami yung followers mo, sobrang dami na, kagaya ng mga, pinakita ko mga daming followers ng dentistry, ng Facebook page, mga dentistry world, mga ganun. Pag dumami ang Facebook page followers mo, yung iba nag-reach na sa millions, pwede mong pagkakitaan yan. Yan, share ko lang. So, pwede nyo siyang pagkakitaan because somebody may contact you or pwede mong i-contactin sila na pwede sila mag-promote ng kanilang products doon or services. Even dentists can do that, lalo na sa mga niche na related sa dentistry. For example, you have a Facebook page na related sa mga puppy. So, you can contact ng mga puppy or dog foods na pwedeng mag-market doon kasi nga ang daming dog lovers na nagla-like. Okay? So, ayun lang na ano ko lang kung how influencers work. Okay? So, Instagram hashtags. Ito naman. If you are a beginner or startup dental clinic and we don't have much enough money or wala tayong relatives to pay the influencers, mga ganon, we can do other strategies like Instagram hashtags for branding and for marketing. Instagram hashtags really work because hashtags improve the SEO, search engine optimization of your post. You get your updates seen by your consumers who are searching for or using the hashtag words. Tama. For example here. Yan, ito. Dito ka magsa-search sa hashtags. Kapag sinerge mo yan, yung unang ag-appear, ito yung may pinakamaraming post. So, consistency rin. And for example, sa dental, for example, at your dental veneer post, we can use a lot of content hashtags like veneer, cosmetic, dental happy teeth, or dental health. Ito yung mga hashtag na frequent na ginagamit. And kapag nilagyan mo ng hashtag yan, una siya mag-appear dito sa mga photos. Kapag may patient na naghahanap ng dental clinic or dental service na mga specific service like veneer, dental implants, ayan, dito po. Dito yung makikita. So, it's really powerful paggamit ng hashtags. Hashtag tips. You can use up to 30 hashtags in your Instagram post, but research suggests 9 hashtags is the magic number for Instagram. Huwag niyo pong sobra-sobra. 9 lang po. So, on Facebook naman, I recommend using 2 to 3 hashtags. Even in Facebook, you can use hashtag. It's really powerful. Ngayon pa napansin nyo, yung hashtag ngayon, nag-blue, kumbaga mas kita na siya. Kung na-notice nyo yung mga changes sa newsfeed ng Facebook, you will notice na yung hashtag nagiging blue, mas clickable siya, mas nakikita siya. So magaling yung pag-brand ng hashtag sa Facebook. you can use it naman sa mga Twitter and mga LinkedIn na hashtags with millions of posts are highly competitive and the chances of your content being seen are much smaller. Okay? Huwag niyo pong makipag-compete sa mga hashtag na ano. Pero the good thing naman is that we are in dental industry. So I think medyo tama lang yung competition sa hashtag. Ito naman yung tip ko. To increase your exposure, I recommend including 3 hashtags with 1,000 plus posts. Tapos may 3 hashtags with yung may 10,000 plus na posts. Okay? And 3 hashtags with around 1,000 posts. Huwag nyo pong, para hindi po siya mag, ano, ma-overwhelm yung Instagram algorithm, 3 lang po kapag na-notice nyo na may 100,000 posts. Saan nyo po makikita kung may 100,000 posts yung ganong hashtag? Okay, dito yan. Ito po yan, makikita nyo dito yan. Ito, sample. O, 296 posts. Yan, masyado ng malaki kung gamitin. Pero competitive na hashtag yan. Yan, so. Okay, so, okay ng hashtag. Okay, ito yung tip ng 13 dental hashtag you need to incorporate in your post. Na pwede nyo gamitin para mas maging effective when you do your Instagram branding. Your location. State your location. Hashtag nyo kung anong location ng inyong clinic. Hashtag Manila, hashtag QC, or very specific location. Okay din. And of course, yung popular hashtag pa sa dentistry is hashtag dental, dentist, hashtag dental humor, hashtag oral health, hashtag healthy living, hashtag dental life, hashtag dental office, hashtag dental clinic. In order po ito. In order. And community hashtags. Ito yung pwedeng mga napapanahon or mga current events like pwede ngayong hashtag COVID, mga ganyan. Pandemic, hashtag shutdown, okay. Shutdown na nangyari, okay? So, your dental service, kung what service yung pinubayad no, or yung pinost mo, for example, kanina, hashtag veneer, hashtag implant, o ganyan, hashtag dental implant, okay? Then, clinic name, for branding, additional branding, don't forget to hashtag your clinic name, and occasion or special holiday, if available. For example, now, hashtag Mother's Day, okay? Mag-post kayo. Mga dental team ng mga mothers doon sa inyong dental office, okay? It's great to connect sa audience nyo. Dapat napapanahon tayo. Dapat very active ang ating social media platforms. So, tip lang, posting consistently is the key for social media success. Kahit alam na natin how it works, kung wala po tayong action, kung walang movement o walang post, kahit napakaganda pa po ng ating mga covers, wala po tayong success sa ating social media branding or marketing. Ayan, lecture flow. Lapit na tayo, natapos na natin ang social media branding, the yellow one. Okay, sa green na po, kapag nakompleto na to, this will guide you para sa progressive and productive social media branding for dental practice. Ayan, ito yung green. What's the green, Doc Kevin? Malapit na. Ayan pa? Okay. Green one is to how to do dental branding in social media. Technically, how to do dental branding in social media. Yung tama. Yung hindi na parang hindi matuturn off yung competitor mo or pati na rin yung follower mo. Okay? This we will discuss here in Instagram or Facebook. This is applicable in Facebook and Instagram. How to do it? Do value-based marketing. I always discuss this. Value-based marketing is really important. Value-based marketing is an appeal to a customer's values and ethics. It shifts marketing from a product-centric approach to a customer-centric one. Okay? Focus po tayo sa patient. Focus tayo sa audience natin. Hindi po tayo sa focus sa mga product or services. Focus po tayo kung paano natin matutulungan ang ating audience. Okay? Value-based marketing. Okay? Explain ko yung mga bumubuo sa customer centricity Ito, dapat customer-focused leadership, understanding your customer, design the experience, empower the frontline, your staff, okay? Metrics that matter, mga datas, it's really important also. And feedback drives continuous improvement. Feedback, always ask for feedback or always ask for the reviews. Like I said kanina, reviews is really important, lalong-lalo sa mga Facebook page, sa dental website, and even doon sa iyong Google accounts. Okay? Because, like I said before, people nowadays, lalong-lalo na ngayon, social distancing, people nowadays will look dentists online. So if you have a good review, you have a 5-star review in your social media accounts, in your websites, in your Google accounts, this will build a very convertible na audience or na ano, yung nag-inquire. Mako-convert natin siya to a high-paying patient. Okay? Dental-based biomarketing have two methods. Ito yung panlaban natin. I know this is very sensitive topic minsan sa mga dental ethics when it comes to marketing. So ito yung na-develop ko na panlaban natin, two methods. How to do it in an ethical way. Number one, informative advertising and attraction marketing. Through informative advertising and attraction marketing. Informative advertising is that it's carried out in an informative manner. The idea is to give the ad the look of an official article to give it more credibility. Also, informative ads tend to help generate a good reputation. Yeah, dapat to inform. Yung main goal natin is to inform the audience. The ad should be informative, occasionally graphic, and usually funny. Truly creative ads get massive recirculation via social networks. Okay? Dapat shareable siya. Kumbaga, funny siya or very informative siya na kung saan ang goal natin is may share ng nakakita. Diba? Hanggang sa makakita na rin ng mga ilang friends nila, then increase the reach and drive additional appointments and patient inquiries sa ating Facebook page, ating Instagram, and other social media accounts. Right? Okay, informative ad sample. In a free strategy, there's a sample. How to keep bad breath away. Mga ganyang style. Then, dapat shareable siya kasi mga beautiful graphics, yung paggagawa, creative, yan. Informative ad in a paid ad sponsored. Ito yung paid ads. Ito yung Facebook ads. Ito yung we did training nung July, Facebook ads. Okay? Medyo ito yung dapat nating matutunan in which na on this type of marketing, we will pay the Facebook. Then Facebook will show the ads to our audience. Sila nang bahala mag-market. Pero you will set up. Yan yung dapat mong matutunan. Because I believe dentists can be marketers too. Okay? So, best part here sa sample natin sa informative ad in a paid ads, yan. Educate first before put a click to learn more. Dapat you should educate first yung reader mo. Yan. Para mas madali siyang mag-clickable yung iyong ad. Funny ads, yan. Mga ganyang sample before or ano, after ng mga funny na shareable ng parang tutuwa sila. Yan. Attraction marketing. What about attraction marketing? Companies, product, or service use carefully devised techniques, strategies. The goal is to attract potential customers to the way the item has been better the sellers online. To attract. There's a magnet, kumbaga. Attract potential customers. Best strategy natin dyan for attraction marketing is you can use some irresistible offers. Kaya nito, sa example natin, sa sponsor nila, they offered a free custom take-home whitening kit. Mga ganyan. You can do that. Ano pa mga ways para sa attraction marketing? Track clients with your before and after photos. I know very effective ito sa Instagram. The before and after photos. Very effective. You can learn also dental photography, right? Daming mga coach ngayon ng mga dentist, mga lecturers na nag-talk about sa dental photography. Document your awesome cases, you can make videos para din shareable siya. And kung paano nyo ginagawa ang ganitong service. Okay. Doc Kevin, what are the types of content naman dentists should ideally publish in their social media feeds? Paano ba, Doc? Ano yung mga good contents? Ito yung top categories. Actually, we have a lot of pwedeng i-post. Pero yung top categories na very convertible or kumbaga, you can have a lot of engagement. Una, first, information about oral care products, dental equipment, services, mga educational materials, deals, promotion, okay lang yan. As long as we do it occasionally, okay? Sa mga special occasions. Patient, testimonial stories, pictures, mga behind the scenes, dental team nyo. Kasi it's a way naman to build relationship when you post mga achievements ng dental team, mga questions for engagement, and holidays, special events, dental events, yung mga natendan nyo po ng mga CE events, yan. Post nyo rin, and motivational quotes. It's very good to share and encouragement posts. Ito yung mga sample natin dyan. Mga educational material, fun fact sample, ayan, correct amount of toothpaste. I know others are practicing this already, which is very good. Yan. Questions for engagement. Ito, very, ano to? Very convertible to. Tataas at tataas ang engagement, ang reach ng iyong Facebook page at Facebook algorithm. Okay, for example, in the morning, which do you do first? Like if you eat breakfast before brushing, comment if you brush before breakfast. Galing, di ba? So, mapapakomment talaga, mapapalike sila. Willing silang sumagot ng mga questions. Yan. How long do you brush? Ganyan. Deals, special offers, giveaways. Okay. It's very sensitive topic doon sa dental ethics natin. But I know we can do this ethically using proper words like special offer. Huwag na po yung mga promotional words. Special offer and occasional lang. Kumbaga, advice is that we do it sa mga opening ng clinics, sa mga anniversaries, mga ganyan. And we have a lot of strategies naman para if you don't want to do the promotion or special offers, we have a lot of strategies to do that, to do more engagement using giveaways and contest. Yan, ito yung example ko. Last time, ito yung sa Christmas giveaway ko. You can see there, we have a lot of engagement and comments and shares, 136 shares. Comments. Kasi ito nga yung mechanics. Like our page, share and like this post, tag friends to qualify or to get giveaways. Yan. Para for fun. Always goal na you have a very fun page na yung page mo. Very engaging siya. Kumbaga, positive yung dating. Pictures and behind the scene. Use social media signs, dental photo booth. Ayan, ito yung mga suggestion ko sa inyo. Mga behind the scenes, mga photos. Another strategy na implement ko sa clinic ko, nag-set up ako ng mini photo booth. Mini photo booth. Then, ayan, very engaging siya. Sa mga kids, lalo na sa mga kids, while they are waiting sa mga their parents na nagpa-picture-picture sila, then they will post it on social media. Lalo na ngayon, nowadays, it's very important to be active in social media. Right? Ayan, ito yung mga social signs. Social signs. This is very popular in other countries, lalo na sa US. Use of photo booth and social signs. Holidays, special events. For example, ngayon, yung Mother's Day, sorry, nakalimutan ko. Mga ganyan, dapat updated yung ating Facebook page. Okay, and also inspirational quotes and if possible, dapat related rin sa dentistry or sa dental health. Yan, yung mga quotes natin. Okay, Doc Kevin, ano naman yung what are the contents that dentists should never, never publish in social media? Yan, okay? Top 3 lang po. Tatlo lang naman, mga, kumbaga, hindi kaaya-aya ng post natin. Bloody pictures. I noticed some post bloody pictures, pero hindi po siya maganda tingnan. But, recommended siya if you are a lecturer. Kumbaga, yung market mo are dentist din. Yung audience mo are dentist if you are a coach. Okay? It's really good naman to post. Kasi if you are doing dental surgery, if you are dental surgeon na do lectures, if you have a course, it's okay lang kasi yung ano mo naman are dentist. Stories of unhappy patient, of course, and negative opinions on your competitors. Yan. Wag po tayong, para yung tamang branding lang, wag po tayong makikipag-away sa mga social media. It's not a good, ano po, branding. Okay. Ito yung mga other suggestion ko to level up your branding strategies using the following advanced branding tools. Yan, mga dental website. You have a dental website, napakalakas ng reputation mo. And dental landing pages to get their data. Full name, address, yan. Dental landing pages. This is very popular to get their names para you can follow up to them anytime or if you have a deals, promotion, or special occasions na giveaways. And dental chatbots, the latest tool naman for mga dentists na you want to maximize their unlimited support or 24-hour support, applicable ito sa mga dental Facebook page. Okay? Ayan! Congratulations! Thank you for staying. Ito na po yung apat na kompleto na po natin ang brand, dental brand identity development, social media branding, ethical social media branding para sa progressive and productive social media branding for dental practice. Okay. So, conclusion lang. In essence, honesty is the best policy in openness and necessity when it comes to social media branding. Make sure you promote with clarity and transparency lang po. Full disclosure is essential in your wish to maintain your practice integrity and avoid damaging patient trust. Okay? Patient trust is really important. Let's move dentistry forward. Madam, mugin nga salamat for listening from me and from galing po sa aking anak. Yan. And like I said, okay, you can click the link or you can message me for the ebook. Yan. Can connect with me anytime. Okay na. Okay, Q&A time. Any questions?
Okay, so Dr. Kevin, maraming salamat. Ano, ang dami nating natutunan, ang daming mga dentist okay, na comment, ang dami ring nanood sa atin. And of course, bago tayo pumasok sa Q&A, sa mga dentista ko pong minamahal, gusto po namin kayong bigyan ng pagkakataon na i-download yung kay Dr. Kevin na regalo sa inyo. Ito po, i-click ko po yung link na ito. Then it's all for you for free, no? So this is a step by step, ayan po, nakikita nyo po sa link that https://levelupwithkevin.onlinesalespro.com/doc. So this is for free. Anytime that you do have a cellphone or laptop or CPU, pwede po sa cellphone, nakaka-download po kayo. So you can use this for your social media branding. And now, Dr. Kevin, ano ba itong mga pakulo natin na Q&A?
Yes, any questions? Baka may mga tanong po tayo dyan.
Actually, nandito lang, Dr. Kevin, is puro pasasalamat at good okay. Lecture from Dr. Kevin, Dr. Abraham Kulbengan, Dr. Abe, magandang gabi sa iyo, Dr. Loranel Derama, Dr. Shir Bakid, Dr. Arnold Garcia, Dr. Shara Manarang, Dr. Irene Mago, Dr. Ariel. So you stay here because we still have a lot of learnings to share. So tatanungin po kayo ni Dr. Kevin kung talaga nakinig kayo. And malay nyo, pabigyan po kayo ng special one-on-one training or seminar or consultation ni Dr. Kevin. So, okay. Dr. Kevin, take it away. Ano ba tong Q&A, Doc?
Ayun nga, yung kung may tanong sila, I will answer any questions. If you have questions po doon sa mga topics natin, sa social media branding, yan. Yun lang, kung any questions lang. If okay. You don't have a question, okay lang po, okay naman. I guess na kung walang question, maybe nasa ano, na ano nyo, na ganito, naintindihan po, siguro.
Ganito lang yan, Doc Kevin. Meron nagtatanong si Dr. Shara, how can we ask for online consultation payment? So there because we are in pandemic today, so a lot of dentists are doing tele-dentistry, which also, that is my advice also. Dr. Shara is asking, do you think, how can we ask, paano yung tamang pagsasabi sa mga pasyente na dapat may bayad yung online or tele-dentistry?
Okay, last time I researched about tele-dentistry, then it's very famous na din sa other countries. Okay, USA, particularly sa US. Wala naman na ano dapat kung paano yung payment. But as usual lang, after the consultation, maybe, or before pala mag-start ang consultation, you can ask na this is not a free consultation. Na same as the procedure nyo na kung nag-consult kayo sa clinic nyo in a traditional way, it's okay lang po na to ask.
So I would like to give an answer to that. There is no such thing as free lunch. No, although you are professional and it's really ethical, it's your choice to give your consultation for free. But the way to strategize is you must have a very good payment system before you can even ask the online consultation payment. So first and foremost, you have to arrange all of those and then you can proceed with the online consultation payment. Second one. So actually, Doc, I would just like to share with this also. Because on May 13, I will be talking about the step-by-step. I will be talking also how much. I'm going to be talking about the new norms of dentistry. And this is going to be part of that. I provided a post-COVID questionnaire that there is already, we are trying to educate, re-educate all the patients that will come inside our clinic that there is a new norm. And the new norm involves consultation fee. So this is one way that you can easily and slowly penetrate into their mind. Doc, may tanong dito, Dr. Kevin. So you can read that, maybe?
Yes, do we need to have an IT staff to maintain and update the social media accounts? What we need, best strategy natin dyan, maybe you can assign in your dental team, anyone, or you can assign, if you don't have a social media manager, maybe you can assign sa mga assistant nyo, or maybe you can hire dental social media managers.
Yeah.
You can hire.
So, Dr. Kevin, if I may just add, no, for those who have asked that particular question, the way to do marketing, you know, I've been a marketing man for probably 20 years already. And Dr. Kevin is a famous dental digital marketing. He has a lot of patients. Actually, he has a lot of clients, not just local, but international. So together with the Dental Marketing Philippines. First, ang mga advice po namin is, you can do it by yourself first or initially, no? But if you want to level up, if we want to reach a level of success in terms of monetary rewards and also some benefits in terms of your lessening the toxicity, value-based marketing. When we talk about value-based, nasabi po ni Dr. Kevin, you have to learn the value-based marketing. So when you talk about value-based marketing, this is customer-centric ang approach po nito. Dapat benefit po ng pasyente ang mararamdaman nila. And we can be able to provide that. No? Dental Marketing Philippines can provide that, or Kevin can provide that because those are actually one of our specialty. So, Dr. Kevin, dami lang po talaga nagpapasalamat dito sa inyo. Dr. Josephine Arago, sabi niya, Dr. Kevin, thank you very much. Dr. Fadul, sabi niya, napaka-selfless naman ni Dr. Kevin for sharing all the information. And another one, Doc. Can you answer this, Doc Kevin?
Is it offending to ask payment 50% before treatment so that patient will also take appointment seriously and will not cancel on the last minute? Worse will not show up in the reason call situation.
Para tricky to, no?
Depends kasi, Dr. Arnel. Depends talaga sa patient din, relationship natin sa pasyente. Usually, kung ang pasyente mo, saan yung question?
Ito, Doc. I have, answer it, and I have answered that.
Idea.
Okay, so Dr. Arnel Paulino Macay, I think I have been communicating with Dr. Arnel already. So we do have an internal strategy. Probably I share it also on May 13 so that you can tune in. But what we do is, if you do have a payment system, specifically credit card, All the treatment, for example, you're offering an ortho, automatic swipe na the whole 2 years or the whole 18 months. If you're anticipated that the treatment would last for 16 months, go ahead and swipe the 16 months with the billing of every month, zero interest. So the patient will probably accept that. So that is a one-way strategy. But if you don't have a payment system, if you cannot accept credit card, probably that would be hard. And in terms, it takes a lot of informal re-education for the patients for you to accept the treatment. Again, you have to learn not just the value, but you have to go into what patient's perspective. So you have to get to those perspective first before you can even comply with all our requests. Okay? So, Doc Kevin, thank you very much. And this one, Doc Kevin. Hello, Doc Kevin. Can you read that, Doc?
Thanks for the, I'll ask, how to reply the negative comment of unsatisfied patient on social media in a professional way, kung paano kaya mag-reply is, of course, state mo yung name nila, then, shall reply negative comment. Sagutin nyo pa rin. Yung iba kasi I notice, others, they delete the negative comments. Always answer. Kung ano yung best answer na ano nyo, the always best answer is to be humble. Sagutin nyo lang kung ano yung problem kasi we don't have a specific naman in the state ni doktora kung anong problem. So sagutin nyo lang, don't delete the comment. Just answer the ano in a humble way.
Okay. Doc, there's another one here from Dr. Aljon Malaluan.
Pwede po kayo kaya ito sa PRC? Ang ano pong pwede?
Yung siguro yung dental digital marketing. But I do have an answer to that. So, but let me see. Let me just give you your comment.
Pwede po. Actually, we have an article dyan sa article on dental ethics. It's okay to advertise. Yung very strict lang sila is the promotion. Pero advertising po is very acceptable po yan, lalong-lalo na sa ibang countries. And then doon naman sa dental ethics, when we reviewed the Philippine dental ethics, nakalagay po doon, it's okay to advertise.
Okay.
So just yung sinabi ko, just apply the two methods, informative advertising and other strategies than attraction marketing.
Correct.
Walang problema doon. Pag-apply nila.
Yeah. So, thank you, Dr. Kevin. Dr. Aljon, before we, because Dr. Kevin and I have been doing a lot of dental marketing lecture, specifically me, I usually travel to different localities in Luzon and in Manila. So I've lectured a lot of dental ethical marketing, 100 ways to promote, 100 ways to really do an ethical marketing. We are allowed to branding. So this is what they call the professional branding. Even PRC is allowing the so-called professional branding. But meron nga lang pong pinagbabawal. There are three basic things that you are not allowed to advertise. Number one, no? Ito po, pakinggan nyo. Number one is you are not allowed to advertise, promote that you are the only clinic that can provide that treatment. Okay? Number two, you are not allowed to advertise or promote that you are the only dentist that can provide the treatment. And number three, the ethics is, of course, you don't literally show the price on the advertisement. But still, of course, may tatanong, sasabihin ni doktor, eh, daming dentist ang nag-promote. Yan lang po. At of course, we can only control what we can control. If we can be able to promote and proceed with the branding that Dr. Kevin's have lectured us, I think we are way better than them. So don't fall on the things that you can control. Focus on the things that you can control. Thank you. Dr. Kevin, this one. From Dr. Richard Lau.
Take the discussion offline. Tell the patient to contact the clinic so you amend this.
Siguro yun yung kaninang comment, ano?
Okay.
Okay. So I think we have actually...
Thank you to sa lahat po nag-attend. Thank you very much sa mga familiar po, mga kilala kong dentist dyan. Thank you for attending.
Matami.
Hindi ko naman mention lahat. Thank you po.
Dok Kevin, pero marami
pa. Reply isa.
Yan, sige. Reply ni Dok.
Reply po lahat yan. Of course, I will take time.
Ayan.
I hope you understand po talaga. I hope. Okay.
Yeah. Actually, ako, we've been discussing a lot of dental marketing since day one, since we founded this one. I'm still continuously learning from the new topic that you are discussing. So this one, from my good friend, the dental cook. Dental cook na ito ngayon, si Dr. Abe. Bukod sa gwapo, magaling magluto. Kasama ko sa Japan to, Dr. Kevin. Nag-lecture ako doon ng dental marketing eh. Si Dr. Abe nandun.
Is it still practical to maintain a website if you have a good social media?
Very good question.
Okay, good question. If you are practicing in the Philippines, actually, the best part to practice or to establish a brand is in social media when it comes to Philippines, sa Pinoy. Kasi Pinoy spend more time in social media and Facebook. But konti, actually konti lang po ayon sa research, ang nag-search mismo sa Google. So it's okay lang kasi ang dental website is more effective in Google. Mas nakikita po siya. Pero just ano, Doc Abraham, pwede rin na stay mo lang po. Just stay your website.
Okay.
Mas maganda po marami tayong branding na pinapakita.
Actually, meron ako, Dr. Abe, I think with Dr. Abe's practice, he can get a lot of international patients. So just like this one, Dr. Kevin, kilala mo ba to? Eh, nag-comment sa baba.
Ito, si best friend. Ay, hindi si saan? Ito si Doc. Hi, Doc.
Ayan, so mula kay Dr. Christine Joy Torres Ruiz, gusto ko lang kumatiin si Dr. Christine Joy Ruiz na maraming salamat dahil ikaw ang naging asawa ko. Happy Mother's Day. I love you very much. So let's proceed with with some topic. Now this one is, thanks a lot, Dr. Liao, noted po, Doc. And we do have this one. So we're going to have more. If you do have more questions, please. Now, we are very much, we're still going to give you probably another 5 minutes so that we will be able to answer your question. And, but before we proceed with the question, Dr. Kevin, ito yung mga nanood sa atin, batiin natin. Si Dr. Marcel Garcia from Davao, no? So we have from Davao, Dr. Maria Gemma Galang is from Manila, Dr. Blesters Jaga, Dr. Mori, Dr. Oscar, Dr. Team, si Alan Morales, Boko ito, Dr. Madge Antonio, Marler Pagsisihan, Dr. Jomer Pasol, Dr. Ann Ross, Bobby, Marlita Anueva, Dr. Ryan De Guzman from Cavite Dental Chapter, Dr. Alessa Garcia has always been supporting, Dr. Jen, Dr. Jer Sibilia, Dr. Pej Abler, Dr. Oliver, magandang gabi po sa inyo, Dr. Sandoval, and BFF na bayan, Dr. Romeo Jacob. Of course, you will see Dr. Romeo Jacob on May 15. He's going to be invited to share with us the Kwentong Dental, and Dr. Ruiz, Dr. Cheryl Rocha, Maria Elena, Dr. Ruimil Pingol. Ang dami po, maraming salamat po. Hindi ko na po mababasa lahat. So again,
thank you po.
Mr. Kevin, with sa iyong pasasalamat naman at maybe a final message because we are not hearing a lot of questions right now. Dr. Kevin, if you do have
again, thank you very much and let's just move dentistry forward and always remember that dentists can be marketer too.
Yon.
Lalahanin yan. Yeah.
Okay. Very good. So kagaya po ni Dr. Kevin, he is a dentist, but he is doing a lot of marketing. Ito, nag-comment si Dr. Abe. Thank you, Dr. Kevin and Roger. Great dental marketing team. Thanks for sharing more power. I think we have to invite Dr. Abe. He's a very good dentist also. Thank you.
Branding.
Maganda
sa branding yan.
Oh, maganda ang branding ni Dr. Abe. I think he have branded like more on elegance. So, we will provide you with some other technique. Thank you, Doc Kevin and Doc Roche. No, yan. Dr. Elizabeth Mendoza, maraming pong salamat, Dr. Kevin. Ano pa ba? Ang dami. Dr. Harris, thank you for answering. So, maraming salamat po sa inyo. Ipapakita ko lang po yung link ni Dr. Kevin uli para at least kung kayo po ay, if you really want to start your Facebook advertising. But before you proceed with Facebook advertising, no, ito pong dental level up with Dr. Kevin, I firmly believe that you have to apply those first. No, yung mga branding and kagaya po nasabi dito, brand is not a logo, push and pull strategy. You have to have a vision. Pero sa May 13 po, meron po tayong presentation about the vision, core value. So I think it's also very important that you watch out that particular webinar that's going to be 6 p.m. May 13, that's going to be yours truly. And we also have tagline and value-based marketing. So those are the things that you have to do before you use the Facebook Dental Branding of Dr. Kevin. Yan.
Oh, yeah. Very good. Yes.
Kilala natin to. Basahin mo, Doc.
Hi, Doc Lagman. Thank you very much. It's an honor. It's an honor. God bless. Happy Mother's Day. Dr. Rafadul. Happy Mother's Day. Yan pa ba siya? Dr. Davalos. Thank you. Thank you.
Dr. Ariel, Ultra Primera Clinic is so thankful. So with that, I think I'm just going to share with you. Huh? Ano, Doc?
Dr. Harris, hello. Galing ng branding nito, Dr. Harris.
Dr. Harris. Dr. Harris. Pakita natin ng next level dentistry. Thank you, Dr. Kevin. Doctor, taga saan po si Dr. Harris, Dr. Kevin? Cebu?
Manila si
mismo. Dr. Kevin. Parang hindi pa tayo na...
Ano nga, Doc, yung branding mo?
nandito kanina, sinesearch niya eh. Okay.
So, last time kanina.
Alam nyo, nung dental marketing po kami sa BISCON, yung Visayas Convention, unfortunately, hindi nakarating si Dr. Kevin. Nesponsoran po namin. Meron po kaming pre-con. No? Pre-con po ay kami po, dental marketing po. And we're able to get good traction. And hopefully, taga-tarlak daw si Dr. Harris. I think next year, so we are going to plan for the next year event. No? So we will be inviting Dr. Kevin to go to Manila because really, Metro Manila is a very good way of we can have great discussion on dental marketing. Again, sa mga dentista pong nandyan, like nyo lang po yung page ng Dental Marketing Philippines or pwede nyo pindutin yung Get Started. Lahat po ng mga replay dito mapapanood nyo po doon. At ilalagay ko din po ito sa Facebook, sa Facebook at saka sa YouTube. Dr. Kevin, anything?
Classmates ko, shout out na yung classmates ko nandyan at si Doc Caniban saka si Doc Mark.
Dr. Mark, yan. Yeah. Si Dr. LP Pisigan, yan. So, thank you very much. Ito pa, si Dr. Dian, Dr. Ganda, ganda-ganda yung Dr. Rodrigo. Salamat po sa pagtitiwala sa dental marketing. At yan po si Dr. Kevin. Maraming pong salamat sa inyo. Dr. Mark, yan. Dr. Mark Andrew Bedoy Gustilla. Dr. Mark! Ayan, si Dr. Mark pala yung past president ng Iloilo Dental Chapter.
Okay, best friend.
I hope that you'll be able to... Nag-lecture ako din.
Drama, yes.
Sana makabalik kami ni Dr. Kevin dyan, no? ang dami pa, Dr. Kevin. So, Dr. Kevin, imbitahan mo naman sila sa May 15 natin. No? Because na-imbitahan ko sila, May 13, ni-imbitahan ko kayo, that's gonna be my lecture, 6 p.m. You're gonna learn a lot, I assure you. No? So, free po ito. So, medyo dami ng libre. Pero okay lang po yan. So, Dr. Kevin, sa May 15.
The May 15 will be the announcement of winners, no? To end together with tatlo tayo?
Yeah, yeah.
With Dr. Jacob. Ayan. Ano ba yung ano?
Okay. So, iniimbitahan po natin kayo sa May 15. Patuloy po kami magbibigay ng saya. Patuloy po kaming magbibigay ng konting guidance with regards to, of course, you know naman, Dr. Romeo Jacob, maraming wisdom yan, eh, no? Marami siyang BFF ng bayan yan, eh. So we will be able to give you more wisdom, guidance, but at the same time, no? Marami po kang kaming ipamimigay na premyo. Yun ang mahalaga doon. So, okay. Dr. Kevin, nagawa po si Dr. Kevin ng registration para po may share nyo sa mga kapwa nyo dentista. Para yung mapapanalunan, magagamit nyo naman sa clinic nyo. No? So, marami pong salamat. So, siguro po, Dr. Jennifer, thank you. Nakahabol sa comment. Siguro, this time is hanggang dito muna tayo, Dr. Kevin. So, paano?
Time na. Thank you. Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day po sa lahat ng dentista. Marami pong salamat. Dr. Kevin, thank you very much.
I see you around.
Okay.
Honor.
Bye-bye. Thank you. So with that, we are able to talk to Dr. Kevin ngayon po, alas sa 7:30 na at alas 8 naman po ng gabi. Manood po kayo, meron pong Zoom meeting naman po yung Magic Core, minimally invasive implant naman yon. So you have to get in there at 8 p.m. tonight, Philippine time. So makikita niyo po, this is from Korea. It's a great also product and marami pong salamat sa pagtangkilik niyo sa Dental Marketing Philippines. Magkita po tayo sa May 13. tandaan niyo po, May 13 at 6 p.m., I'm pretty sure I'll be able to share with you 3 phases of dentistry. And number 2, I'll share with you the new norms. And number 3, magkano. Magkano na yung single as per your computation. With that, thank you very much. We're saying goodbye tonight. See you on May 13. Bye-bye.